We want to simplify the following expressions. And looking at these examples, that means you want to determine the product. So for the first example, we have 3 times 5x. But remember, 5x means 5 times x. So all 3 of these are connected by multiplication. And using the associative property, we could write this as 3 times 5 times x. And since 3 times 5 is equal to 15, 15 times x is equal to 15x. The second example, we have negative 7a times 4. And again, the negative 7 and a are connected by multiplication. So by using the commutative property of multiplication, we can change the order of this if we wish. So it might be helpful to write this as negative 7 times 4. Let's go ahead and group those two together, times a. Well, negative 7 times 4 is negative 28. And negative 28 times a is equal to negative 28a. Now we have negative 2x times negative 5y. So we can think of this as negative 2 times x times negative 5 times y. So again, let's go ahead and change the order of this multiplication using the commutative property. And we'll also change the grouping using the associative property. So we'll have negative 2 times negative 5, let's group those two, times x times y. Well, negative 2 times negative 5 is positive 10, and x times y is just equal to xy, and 10 times xy is equal to 10xy. And for the last example, we have 2m times 5m, or 2 times m times 5 times m. So we can write this as 2 times 5 times m times m. Well, 2 times 5 is 10, and m times m is m to the second, or m squared, so this would be 10m squared. So I know after you do a few of these, you probably won't show as much work as I am here, but I think when you're first learning how to do these, it can be helpful.